Hello, I'm Dr. Sriram Ramalingam, Medical Director, Pradnya Nethralaya, Artinagar, Bengaluru, specialized in cataract, glaucoma, squint, and refractive surgeries. What is diabetes mellitus? Diabetes mellitus is a condition where the blood sugar levels are high. So what is the complications of diabetes and the body? Diabetes affects all the organs of our body, including our eyes. What happens in long-standing diabetes mellitus is that the blood vessels that carry the blood over a period of time becomes very sticky. It starts leaking fluid, blood, and blood products into the organs of the body. This, over a period of time, can lead to decreased oxygenation to the various organs of our body and lead to further complications. All these problems occur in the whole body in people with uncontrolled diabetes. But eye is the only structure where these problems can be visualized by a doctor. So the condition is called as diabetes retinopathy. That is, the changes that occurs in the retina, that is the light sensitive portion of the eyes, which converts the light energy into electrical signals and transmitted to the brain, it affects the most sensitive area of the eye. Who are affected by these diseases? People with long-standing diabetes mellitus, people with uncontrolled diabetes mellitus. The other risk factors are hypertension, dyslipidemias, ethnicity. Occasionally, it can occur during pregnancy and lactation. The most important thing is duration of diabetes and uncontrolled diabetes. See, what happens in diabetic retinopathy is blood vessels supplying to the retina gets damaged. That is, it starts leaking blood products onto the retina. They are classified into two types, non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy and the severe form, what is called as a proliferative diabetic retinopathy. In non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, they may be mild, moderate or severe. In the mild, you have few hemorrhages because of the leaking of the blood products. In the mild or slightly moderate form, you may get little aneurysms can occur, leaking of the blood products. As the condition progresses, it becomes a severe. When the oxygen supply to the retina decreases, the retina releases certain chemicals which causes new blood vessels to grow to supply oxygen to the retina. This condition is called as a proliferative diabetic retinopathy. Proliferative diabetic retinopathy is a serious complication. It can lead to hemorrhages in the retrace or in the eye. It can lead to shrinking of the retina because of the fibrosis, and a person can lose vision. It can also lead to what is called as a neovascular glaucoma. Another entity in diabetic retinopathy is called as a diabetic maculopathy. Here, there is a leakage of fluid in the center part of the eye, which is called as a macula, which is a light sensitive area. It is very important for seeing clearly. How is diabetic retinopathy diagnosed? Diabetic retinopathy is diagnosed on a complete eye examination by an eye surgeon. A person has to undergo a dilated eye examination where he can pick up the diabetic retinopathy changes. If a person has got diabetic retinopathy changes, your doctor may advise certain other investigations like fundus fluorescent angiography, optical coherence tomography to find out the extent of the fluid and the extent of damage to the retina. Treatment of diabetic retinopathy is first and foremost is a good control of your diabetes. The treatment of the eye problem may include laser treatment, injections into the eye called as anti-vegf injections, or a combination of both. Occasionally, steroids injections are also given in the eye to prevent the complications of diabetes. But along with all these treatment, a good control of diabetes is very important. If you do not control your diabetes, these treatments are of no use. So, take home message, all persons with diabetes should have a complete eye examination, not a glass power checkup by an ophthalmologist. We should include an intraocular pressure measurement, a dilated retinal examination. How frequently should this be done depends upon the status of your diabetes. If your diabetes is well controlled, once in a 6 months to once a year is enough. If your diabetes is not well controlled, once in 3 to 4 months is essential. So consult your ophthalmologist as early as possible, as and when required.